Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos and today I'm going to show you that manual bidding is finally working again, at least for Europe. For those that you know me before iOS or you follow me for a long period, you know that manual bidding was one of my most volatile methods and it brought a lot of money and it helped me scale several businesses. Of course, with the delayed reporting of up to 72 hours in the United States and stuff, it's becoming more and more difficult to use it. But we have noticed that, and by we I'm talking about several marketeers, that in Europe the delayed reporting is much less hours. So let me tell you how this affected the manual bidding. There are some accounts, Switzerland, Germany, France, Spain, Italy, United Kingdom not so much, but for everything else except from United Kingdom in Europe, I'm watching some very good results with manual bidding. Why? I do believe that we have less hours delayed reporting, which is helping a lot with the manual bidding method and how it's working. Let's go into my PC to show you how I scaled in just 2 or 3 days a business to big numbers. And we will take it from there so that I can explain to you how the manual bidding is working again and again. And maybe you can start using it if you are in a European account. I'm starting using it again in United States. I haven't seen anything huge yet, but I will keep you posted if something changes. So let's go and let me show you the account that is doing very well right now with manual bidding and why I think that it's working better from any other campaign that we're running right now. It's also helping me to scale a lot. And then we're going to discuss a little bit about some United States accounts that I'm running some manual bidding, but it's not working. So if we go here on this account, I will take you by days just in this period just to see what is happening. So if we go on the Saturday, so this is the whole account on Saturday, let's go on Saturday. So on Saturday the spending was 4.5k in total. Okay, we have our manual bidding campaigns, some of them, and then we are having our normal campaigns, and of course we are selling different products here and there. But again, I want to focus a little bit on the numbers and what kind of ROAS we're getting from the other campaigns. Of course, we cannot see the average numbers here because the manual bidding is using one day click. One introduction about manual bidding. What is manual bidding? When you're creating one campaign, the manual bidding is something else, but my manual bidding method, I guess. When you're creating one campaign, when you go here, of course, let's select a pixel. Let's have a conversion event of purchase. There you go. And now what you're doing is, instead of conversions here, you're going to put value and you're going to put 3.3 ROAS or whatever. Again, the ROAS that you're going to put here, it's going to be dependent on what you can actually achieve on the account, and you're going to put a little bit higher just so that you can be safe. The option here is going to be not on 7 days clicking, but on one day after click, because we want these to every day have very big budgets, like something like 200, but it's not going to spend all of it. Okay, now let me show you one campaign here that it's not spending. For example, in this one here, we are having one manual bidding in the United States that it's not spending. Okay, we have set it exactly the same. We are having over here our different thing, 1.8 ROAS, because in this channel, account, we can actually have 1.2 ROAS and be profitable. So I'm putting it higher, and one day after click. And as you can see here, even while I'm having $200 budget here, it's not spending this money because it cannot find sales. So what am I going to do? I'm going to decrease it a little bit and start seeing if it can work. Again, I think that in United States, the manual bidding is not working yet. I hope that it's going to work in the future because I have to scale a lot of accounts with it. But let's go back to Europe now, and in Germany, where this account is, we can see that when we're talking about the 1st of this month, 1st of August, the manual bidding that we were running in this period, it was 1.1K out of the, let me discard this draft also. Refresh, doesn't discard like this. Facebook is full of bug, guys. Okay, discard it, and now we can work on it. So now if we see here, we can see that it has 4.5k spent on October 1. We can see that we have 4.56, even though we're having a 3.3 ROAS in our value. And of course, what I started doing after that point is that I'm starting observing the amount spent and I'm starting to increase my different budgets. How do I do that? I group all of the campaigns that I have with manual bidding. I'm coming here because, by the way, manual bidding is ABO. We never use CBO. And we're coming here and we're seeing what they are spending and we're increasing budgets daily. Why? Because it's safe, you know. If the manual bidding is working properly, it's not going to spend more from what you set it to spend. And by the way, it's not going to spend it without having the results. So the other thing that happened is that on Sunday, I managed to do more campaigns and stuff and actually start scaling the budgets like this because it's safe. On Sunday 2 of October, I spent 6K and the manual bidding over here is almost 50% right now. Okay, so close to 3K. 3.87, of course, the ROAS is dropping a little bit, but this is totally fine. This account has a break-even ROAS of 2.5, so we are golden. Then on the Monday, on 3 of October, we have 3.78 with 5K spent. As you can see, I'm scaling super fast with manual bidding. There is no other way to scale with other kind of things, even with crazy methods and stuff, you cannot scale so fast. So out of the 8.4K spent over here, we can see that we have the 5K being spent in manual bidding. So let's see what happened yesterday. Yesterday we spent 4.2K. Most probably this is the point that we downscale, okay, 7K. So we spent 4K on manual bidding, 3K on our other campaigns. Again, super profitable, 3.69. At this point, I'm deciding what to keep, what to lose from manual bidding. Increase the budgets. For example, you see that this one that is actually having very good results. Let's see the maximum results of this one. The results of this one, for example, we can see that it has 6.47. I'm increasing more the budget and it's actually ready to spend it. So yesterday I increased it to 1,200, 870. Let's see what is happening today. Today so far we have a 2K spending. This campaign is moving very fast. So most probably what am I going to do? I wanted to spend more, you know, if it's working, it has 5 ROAS. This campaign is on fire right now and it's moving very well. Let's do some optimization together here in the manual bidding, since we're seeing that today we're on 4.3. Yesterday, to be honest with you, I scaled a little bit, I slowed down because I was watching that it was close to 3. So I went to a lot of these and I changed the budget so that I can slow it down, and it ended up being 3.7. Because again, even if it's Germany, we have some small delay on the reporting. So let's see what is happening here today. We see this one is on 3. I don't want to touch this one. I think it's fine, but this one on 4, I think I can touch it. Let's see what is happening on the last 7 days with this one. Very solid results, super solid results. So let's go today on this one, 400 for sure. I'm going to go with this one on 800 and see if it's going to spend it profitably. Another thing is that we can now sort it by ROAS and see what we're having. So let's touch the ones above. So 5 ROAS, we have already changed it. This one, for example, let's see what it's doing on the last 7 days. 2.4, I don't want to touch it. Today it's doing better. I'm going to give it a small push to see if it's going to continue like this today. Keep into your mind that manual bidding is not like the other campaigns. You should watch your ads every 1 or 2 hours because this thing can get really bad. And when it's working, it's super rewarding. You can scale. This account, for example, was spending 60K per month, and now the previous month we spent 250K. Crazy scaling that you can do. Only manual bidding can do this kind of stuff. And I have also other case studies that I'm showing how it's happening. Here we can see another campaign with 9, but these are small spends and stuff, so I don't wanna do anything yet here. Here's also small spend. This one, no. I don't think I should touch anything else. In 2 hours, maybe the situation is going to be different and I will touch something else, slow down something. Let's see, by the way, if we have to slow something, okay? So based on the spend, basically, let's go here, 66. This one, for example, 1.57, but I don't consider this such a bad thing. Let's see also what is happening on the last 7 days with this one. 2.17, it's still fine because we want to have some of those for volume also. Let's see today what else is happening. All the others look fine. Do we have anything that is super spending super fast without the results? No. So for us right now, this one is actually a campaign that is actually tracking the results. I have some last notes about manual bidding. I showed you also the other accounts that's not always working. So don't be disappointed if you do it and it doesn't work for you. Just play with the ROAS and try to see if it's going to work for you. Last note. Except from the fact that manual bidding is extremely volatile, except from the fact that it's working like this, and if you manage to make it work, it's going to be extremely rewarding. I can tell you that it's not working in all accounts, so be careful, please. The last point I have to make about manual bidding is that the campaigns are dying super fast, okay? So the campaigns and the ad sets, because it's an ABO. So over here, this ad sets that some of those are working for the previous days very well, they are going to die. So what you have to do is duplicate and do it all over again, because this is in 1 day attribution. 1 or 2 days with bad results might slow down your ad set so much that it wouldn't make any sense for you to keep it. So over here right now, I'm in the process of actually launching new campaigns, trying to see if I can scale more. Of course, I have this beast over here, which is going to do well. Imagine just with one ad set being able to spend 1,800. But other than that, I can see others that they slow down and stuff. So I'm going to take all of these ad sets and duplicate them again. So I will end up having 44 ad sets now that I will have to manage and see how much they're going to spend and scale, and do this every 2 hours, watch them how much they spend, play with the budget and stuff. It needs a lot of effort. It needs a lot of instinct, and it needs for you to have zero life like me and be all day on PC. It's extremely rewarding, and you can scale businesses like this. I think it's super technical. I think some of you will not understand it, some of you will not do it, some of you, you're going to lose money in the process of doing it. But for the few people in the channel that they have the technical knowledge, guys, test it and let me know in the comments if it worked for you. If you are an amateur, this is not a method for you. So that's all I had about manual bidding. I think that the results are super intriguing, and they talk by themselves. If you're in Europe, you should start testing the manual bidding. I think it's very effective. I will wait your comments on it. Be careful, guys. It's a volatile method. Let me not repeat myself. I don't want you to lose money because you are trying it. Don't forget to put 1 day attribution. You might regret it. And don't forget that if you want to learn more about manual bidding or any other method, you can check my book or my free course. And until we meet again, guys, be creative and be consistent.